been sitting at your computer since the last time we left. So we've been on a hiatus.
Sort of. Pretty much nothing was coming
out that we really cared about, other than like...
Now that November started, we're gonna get back into it a little bit.
Plethora.
We're gonna talk about the album we're doing this video for, and then the rest of the month we'll be doing the albums that we missed this year before the end of the year.
We'll be doing that, waiting in mind at the new Sonic.
So the album that we're reviewing, I can't talk. definitely one of the highly, all the albums we pretty much have been highly anticipated. This one's a big one. Devil You Know's second album, They Bleed Red. They put this album out really, really fast. The first album, it's been like a year and a half since the first album came out. You never see a band do that anymore.
Because when we went to go see them on the Golden Gods tour, I remember we were talking to Francesco and the bass player, and they both said that they had been way ahead of schedule. Like, they had been writing music for a while, and everything was done. The only problem was that their label wasn't allowing them to release all the material. You have to kind of space it out. Mm-hmm. So this is the second installment in the legacy of Devil You Know.
Yes. To sum up this album, the first album was phenomenal.
Yes.
So that's why I was really, really anticipating, you know, this the second album gonna sound like.
Right.
This album is acceptable.
It is acceptable. And it's a better on a second listen.
That's not a word you'd want to use for an album. Acceptable.
Yeah.
It's not a good word to use. And why is it acceptable?
It's acceptable, for several reasons, but one of the big ones is the fact that, some of these guys are getting older. Mm. I've never heard Howard's vocals struggle so much. He sounds totally different, and you can hear the straining in his voice now. He does those fry screams, but now even those are starting to diminish a little bit, and it's... One of the big things about this band was that when they came out, it was like the return of Howard Jones.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
The first album had hype.
Right, it had a lot of hype.
You know, it was the comeback. It was the first album from this super group of members. And, you know, that's another thing that made the first album really great.
Yeah.
Is the hype behind it, and then obviously the music itself.
Right.
I thought was, extraordinary. This album doesn't have that.
Yeah, this album is really a return to normality for what these guys have, what they used to do. Mm. You hear a lot more blast beats, and I think that was the thing with the first record was that, they were trying to really nail down their sound. And the first record to me was an incredibly diverse record. Looking at it from that perspective, I think maybe they were looking to maybe we'll put like a variety pack kind of like of what we're writing and see which kind of songs people gravitate more towards on the first record. And I think maybe they felt that people were gravitating more towards the harder stuff than, something maybe like, and not to say that any song on that record isn't, walls to the wall awesome, but it's just, they're different now. That was, this is a very capable group of guys. One of the big things about this, like I said, was, Howard, being able to come back and being able to make music again, and to hear, what made Howard an exceptional vocalist in the eyes of a lot of people were his clean vocals. And unfortunately, after we saw them the first time live, you can tell that Howard really can't do a lot of that stuff anymore. He can still scream okay, he still does fry screams well, but without that's missing the element that made him exceptional. He sounds okay in the studio when it's mixed and things like that, but I guarantee you that most of the material, like Eye of the Tiger, Howard could never sing Eye of the Tiger live, ever.
That's a good cover.
An incredible cover.
It's a very good cover, but maybe it's not something he could probably do.
Right, and that's, the kind of the trade-off is, you get this killer music, but unfortunately, a lot of it is produced, and, you're probably not going to get the same experience that you did live, because the bass player does a lot of the Howard's clean vocal.
One argument I have with this album, apparently this album is heavier. How so? I don't find it to be heavier than the first album.
That's a really crazy question, because how do you define heavy?
I think this album has less heavier songs than the first album did.
I think
you get songs like Let the Pain Take Hold and Searching for the Sun, And then even an acoustic song, I mean, that's a I Am Alive, which is, but that's a bonus track.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's, I think I can argue that this album is not heavier than the first album.
It has its moments where I think it is slightly heavier than
the
first
record. like Consume the Dam.
Yeah, those songs are
Stay of Execution.
And yeah, Stay of Execution is one of the ones that really jets out. You know, from the background that all these guys had, this record makes a lot more sense to me than the first record did. Now that being said, on a scale of 1 to 10, where do you think this record would stand?
It's hard to say.
It is, isn't maybe. It? And I think that's an interesting observation.
I'd say maybe, I say 7, maybe.
Yeah, it's about probably what I would give it.
I don't want to give it an 8, but...
I feel like almost the first record was so good that this record was almost slightly doomed. A little bit, because I mean, it. How do you follow up something that was done that well? I mean, it's, you know, these guys are masters, so I didn't want to put it past them. But in my head, I kind of always had a little bit of doubt that this record was going to be equally as good as the first one. If you look at it from the first record being sort of a variety pack of what they're writing, maybe the reason why, you know, this record was. They felt maybe that this record was a little bit more cohesive and like kind of all, like the songs were more similar. Because that's a vibe I get, is like when you listen to it the first time, it's like if you space out, you'll lose track of
what song it is.
Exactly. So you need like, and that's a very different experience from the first record. Mm-hmm. Because the first record, it was very like, the songs were their own story. And it's like this record kind of gets not lost in the muck, but... it's
easy to lose track,
right? And that's the problem. Well, that's an issue that we've had with a couple of records this year, and that like All That Remains is record. Mm-hmm. You know, that was a record that it was easy to, you know, kind of lose space out and lose your way, and it was just background noise, not background noise, but you know what I mean. So
this record's in a tough position.
It is. It really doesn't have anything helping it.
I'm happy that at least there's new music from them. Check out They Bleed Red.